Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So this video will be about 6 battle tips on Fire Emblem Heroes. The first one is, know the weakness and strength of each color or type of units. You can see the damage dealt and taken preview on the top of the screen. So the simplest thing is the color triangle. Red wins against green, green wins against blue, blue wins against red. Other than color triangle things, the other example is archers can do a lot of damage to flying units. So do not put your flying unit in front of the enemy's archer. Your flyer can get killed like easily. When you are trying to move your character, there will be an exclamation point marked on the enemy. It means that enemy can do huge damage to your unit. So be careful about that one. And yeah, you can see the damage dealt and the damage taken on the top part of the screen. So before you execute your action, make sure that you can win the fight. Do not execute an action that can make your unit getting killed. Okay, so the second tip is use a decoy to make the enemy move. Use the danger area button to see where they can move and attack or click them one by one. Sometimes the opponent just don't want to move at all, even after you move some of your characters. Use the danger area button to see where they can move and attack, or click them one by one. That way you can see where they are gonna attack and things. Just put one character that can endure the damage taken on one of the block that they are gonna move or attack. And just keep the other units on safe area. That way, you can make the enemy move and chase you like crazy. The tips number 3, positioning. Try to keep the distance and try to attack first. Do not let your unit getting attacked by more than one enemy. Okay, so after you use the decoy tactic, they will chase you, right? Try to keep the distance, move to area that the enemy won't be able to attack you, and they will chase you. That way, you can attack them first instead of they attack you. If your unit's attack is high enough, you can even one turn kill that enemy. With the correct element, the correct weapon, the correct unit, you can one turn kill that enemy. This strategy is very, very good for sword unit to kill mage enemies. Because if the mage attack your sword unit first, there is a possibility that your sword unit can get killed first, especially if their res is very low. And when you decided to attack the enemy, try to make sure that you won't get attacked by more than one enemy, because most likely your unit won't be able to take the damage, unless it's a tank against physical attacker and things. So you have to make sure that your unit will be able to endure the damage taken. The fourth tip, take the advantage of skills, buff and debuff. For example, Lucina's Falchion, it can do more damage to dragons and effective against red, blue and green color units. That's just the example of weapon. About the buff and debuff, there are some units that have, you know, attack down debuff, like defend down debuff, rest down debuff. And there is also units that give defense buff, attack buff and things. For example, if you put attack down debuff on the enemy and if you give your unit defense buff, your unit won't take much damage. There is also a possibility that your unit will take 0 damage instead. The fifth tip, take the advantage of the map's terrain. Sometimes on a certain map, there is a small path, just one line. And you can put your stronger color unit against weaker color enemy. For example, you can put your red unit against green enemy and let your red unit become your tank, something like that. Or you can use your archer, mage to attack across the wall, because archers and mage have 2 range attacks. If the opponent is a melee character, I mean like sword user, axe, lance, they won't be able to attack back if you attack them with Tom unit, I mean magician, or maybe shurikens, archer and things, they won't be able to attack back. So that way you can do free damage, yes, by taking the advantage of the map's terrain. The sixth tip is when you are trying to do a quest, you can see the opponent's colors, right? If there are only physical attacker, you can try to use units with high defense in your squad. That way you can win a lot easier. Well, make sure that at least you have like one magician that can do good damage, because sometimes the enemy can have like very high defense that your physical attacker cannot attack at all. And if there is no archer on the opponent, you can try to bring flyers. Yes, flying units, because flying units can move across the map like easier. They can move across mountains. You can make a good use of that part. And if the enemies, they are like most of the magicians or all of the magicians, instead of using high defense unit, you can try to bring high res unit. Yes, you can see the stats. So build your squad depend on the quest that you are going to do. That's the best way. You can win even with 3-4 stars character if you can take the advantage of that part. Okay, so I think that's all for now guys. Hope this video can be helpful for you guys, and press the like button if you like this video, share it to your friend, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye bye, Fire Emblem Heroes. Bye.